How many sets of data can you think about that would naturally have a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1? Not a lot, right? That's, you know, not something I can even think of, really. So how do we get to that point, since we've got this one table that assumes we have a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1? Well, if we convert every value in our data set to a z-score, and if that data is already normally distributed, then the mean becomes 0, standard deviation is 1. Okay, just converting everybody to z-score would give us a mean of 0, standard deviation of 1. Okay, so we're going to add one little step to what we're doing. We're going to get obviously a word problem, but we're going to need to convert the information in our word problem to a z-score, and then it goes from there. So just as a reminder, our formula for z-score is x minus x bar divided by s, okay? Or we could do z equals x, that'd be big X, minus mu divided by sigma, okay? All right, so remember that. So here comes our first word problem. I'm excited. Sigma. Mm-hmm. Okay, it says, assume that adults have IQ scores that are normally distributed with a mean of 100 and a standard deviation of 15. For a randomly selected adult, find the indicated probability of an IQ score greater than 70. Okay? Our new keyword for this section is normally distributed. Okay? When we hear that something is normally distributed, then chances are we're not looking at our binomial formula. We're going to be pulling out our table or getting our calculator to use normal CDF or inverse norm. Okay? Something else I want to point out here that I want you to pay attention to while we're in this section is that we're going to be looking at selecting an individual. A little bit later, we're going to be looking at selecting a group and looking at their average. So we know it's normally distributed, and we're looking at a randomly selected adult. Okay, so what I'm going to do is first write what they're asking me to look for. We're interested in the probability that X is greater than 70, okay? Because I know that this is normally distributed, I can convert that 70 to a z-score using my z-score formula. We said z equals X minus X bar divided by S. So X is 70. My mean is 100, and my standard deviation is 15. Okay, we calculate that on our calculator. Looks like we get, did you get negative 2? Okay, negative 2. That's what I got. Okay, so now I can say, yes, I'm looking for a probability that X is greater than 70. That's the same thing as saying the probability that Z is greater than negative 2. And that brings us to everything we just talked about, okay, where we use our table or our calculator. I might make a quick little sketch to figure out which way I want to go with this. Negative 2 is over here. I want to be greater. So what would be the quick way to get to the answer for this? Doesn't really matter to me. Calculator or table or? Table, okay. All right, if I'm using the table, when I look up negative 2, it gives me this piece as my table value. What am I going to do with that? Subtract it from 1. So when I look up negative 2, in my table, okay, negative 2. Let's see if I can get rid of this. All right. we get 0.0228. So 1 minus 0.0228 okay, that leaves me with what? 0.9772. Okay, so the probability of randomly selecting someone whose IQ is greater than 70 is about 98%. Which part? Okay. Questions about that? Not so bad, right? Hopefully this will become your favorite type of problem. All right. Okay, next example. All right, women's heights are normally distributed with a mean of 63.8 inches and standard deviation of 2.6 inches. The U.S. Air Force requires that pilots have heights between 64 inches and 77 inches. Find the percentage of women meeting the height requirement. Okay, so first, what do we notice about this problem that should make us excited? What? It's normally distributed, all right? We should feel like we know what to do, okay? What are we looking for? The probability that 64 is less than X is less than 77, or X is between 64 and 77, okay? And so now I've got to convert both of these things to Z-scores, okay? So I can do that. For 64, we get 64 minus what? 63.8, and we divide that by 2.6. Okay, that's our standard deviation. Okay, 64 minus 63.8 is 0.2. Is that right? Yes. Over 2.6 gives me, okay, 0.0769, so I'm going to call that 0.08, all right, because we're rounding z-scores again. Here we are, we're going to round those z-scores to two decimal places, all right, okay. All right, then for 77, we do z equals 77 minus 63.8 and divide that by 2.6. So we get what? Possibly. Let's see. 77 minus 6. Okay, we'll go with that. 5.08. That's tall women. But that's almost all of them. We'll take anybody. Okay, so if that's right, we get probability that 0.08 is less than Z is less than 5.08. Okay, this one might be a good candidate for us to use our calculator to find. Okay, I'm going to use what on the calculator? Normal CDF. Very good. So we go to second. Distribution, number 2 is normal CDF. My lower bound is 0.08. My upper bound is 5.08. That's almost everybody. Who could be outside of that? Whoa. 0.08, did I do that correctly? Okay. Oh, duh. I wasn't thinking about the negative values. Okay, good. All right, so 0.46081. So there are a lot of people. I forgot about negative Z-scores. 0.81. Okay. All right, what's the question? Find the percentage of women meeting the height requirement. looks like 0.4681. Okay, in order to be in the U.S. Air Force, if this is true, you have to be what? About height. Your height has to be what? Any ideas? Above average. Why would I say that? How do I know these heights are above average? They're above zero. The Z scores are above zero. And then, yeah, we can look back at it. The mean was 63.8, so you have to be above average height for women. Okay. But remember, the mean for a Z score, standard normal Z score, is what? Zero. So we saw that here as well. Okay. Very good. All righty. I'm going to let you try this next one on your own to see if you got it. All right, so an interesting problem here. The lengths of pregnancies are normally distributed, yay, with a mean of 268 days and a standard deviation of 15 days. One classical use of the normal distribution is inspired by a letter to Dear Abby, in which a wife claimed to have given birth 308 days after a brief visit from her husband, who was serving in the Navy. Given this information, find the probability of a pregnancy lasting 308 days or longer. What does the result suggest? Okay, so we're interested in the probability that X is what? Okay, greater than or equal to. I'm glad you said that. In a normal distribution, the equal to doesn't matter. Whether we say greater than or equal to makes no difference. And I'm not saying you're wrong. I just want to point this out. Because this is a continuous distribution. So there are infinitely many values that this thing could actually take on. And so the probability of really being equal to any one is zero. Okay? But we always talk about an interval. Versus in the discrete distribution, greater than versus greater than or equal to makes a huge difference. Okay, so keep that in mind. But that's fine. There was something else I wanted to say. We haven't really been focusing on what X is, but in this case, X is the length of the pregnancy. All right, so that's what X represents. So we're looking at the probability that the length of the pregnancy is greater than or equal to 308. All right, and we know that it is what? Normally distributed. So we're going to find our Z value. We get 308 minus the mean of 268 divided by 15. That came up to what? 2.67. Okay. All right. So we're interested in the probability that Z is greater than 2.67. Okay. I'm going to use my calculator to find that because I'm tired of looking at the table. And so we get second distribution, normal CDF, my lower bound is 2.67, and my upper bound is infinity, big number. And so I've got 0.0038. Okay. So, what does this suggest about What do the results suggest? It's not likely. Very unlikely. Not impossible, but very unlikely. Okay, maybe this is a case for Maury Povich or something like that.
I was just wondering the
same thing. Yeah, you know. Something like that. Okay. Yeah, I mean, yeah, not likely, but yeah. Okay. Here's a new idea. I'm gonna throw this on you right before we leave so that you can think about it. It says, if we stipulate that a baby is premature, if the length of pregnancy is the lowest 3%, find the length that separates premature babies from those who are not premature. Okay? What's the difference in what they've asked us to do in this second part versus the first?
The
Okay. All right. They gave us the percentage, right? Versus all before, they've been giving us the X value. We converted that to a Z and then to a probability. Now, this one starts with the percentage, and they're asking us to find the length, the X value. Okay, that's when the Mr. Green Jeans thing comes into play. So I start from the end here, and we're talking about the lowest 3%. Now, sometimes you got to stop and think about that. And there's an example a little bit later. I won't go into it now. But I will say that the lowest is not always the worst, and it's not always necessarily on the left side. Look for that in some of the other examples. But here, remember, this number line represents for us length of the pregnancy. So the shorter lengths would be on this left end. Okay? Does that make sense? All right. versus, oh well, and what percentage do we want to have here? 3%. So we're going to write that as 0.03. Okay, and I'm going to circle that to remind me that that's a probability or an area. So then I need to find the z-score that allows me to have 0.03 to the left. So I'm going to use my calculator and do inverse norm and 0.03, and I get negative 1.88. Okay, but how do I get that back to an X value? Well, if you take the z-score formula and manipulate it, we get that X is equal to X bar plus Z times the standard deviation. Okay, you could actually, when you know, don't have anything else to do in your board, take the z-score, use a little bit of algebra, and solve for X. And that's what you'll get, okay? Remember, we said a z-score tells us how many standard deviations a value is from the mean. And that's exactly what this looks like. We got the mean plus the number of standard deviations that this thing is from the mean. So for us, our z-score comes up to negative 1.88. So we're going to say x-bar, which was 268, plus our z-score is negative 1.88, and the standard deviation is 15, okay? So 268 plus negative 1.88 times 15, and we get what? 239.8. Okay, so we would say the lowest 3% of the lengths would be for 239.8 days and less. Okay? So we had to turn that thing around. So you got to pay attention to what the question is asking you to find. Okay? We'll do a few examples like that in some more portions of the video. But for now,